so I'm here with my mother, Pam. Mom, I'm making this movie, and the title of this movie, it's an educational movie, the title is Michael Parenti vs. Rod Stewart. So now, without knowing any of the details, now this might be a challenging task, but could you maybe just comment on the outcome? Just based on the title.
Well, you're gonna win.
Spoken like a true mother. Okay, thank you so much, Mom.
Sorry, Michael. I have to go with Rod Stewart.
Yeah. Rod Stewart?
Rod Stewart.
Rod Stewart?
Michael Parenti.
Michael Parenti.
Michael Parenti.
Michael Parenti.
Looks like I have a lot to prove now. Here we go.
Hustler.
Where does Rod Stewart come into this? Actually, I was inspired by one of Rod Stewart's songs to start thinking about this problem. The song is Rhythm of My Heart. And let me play you just a little clip of it so you can hear a lyric that got me thinking about this. Here we go. Okay, so there it is. There's our friend Rod, all right? Some two tough girls gave this to me, thank you. Anyway, the lyric in question was, where the ocean meets the sky, I'll be sailing. So then that got me thinking, well, where does the ocean meet the sky? How far away is the horizon? I would imagine that this answer would differ depending upon one's perspective. However, from my perspective, Michael Parenti, my eyeballs are somewhere around 5.5 feet off the ground. So from this vantage point, how far away is the horizon?
According to the ancient Greeks, the horizon represents a boundary circle. So it represents hope for us. We can always see it, and it's always just past our reach.
Here's a diagram. Here's a nice, simple version of the Earth. Circle. We assume that. The radius of the Earth. This is something that we know. And this would be my 5-foot measurement right here. So this is me standing right here. And I'm looking to the horizon. This line right here is representing my line of sight. So where the ocean meets the sky, at this point right here, this would be Rod Stewart. That's him out there sailing. My question is, how far away is that? Let's call that X, that distance right there. Being that this line of sight turns out to be a line tangent to some curve, from basic geometry, we know that tangent lines form a right angle to a radius of the circle of the tangent to. The measurements that I'm dealing with are all in miles. My little measurement right here is in feet. So first, I thought, let me bring it all to a common unit, miles. How many miles is 5 feet? Well, we know that 1 mile is 5,280 feet, so you can just multiply by this factor, and we see that it's this very small quantity in miles. Okay? Going back to the right triangle, one thing that we know about right triangles is that the Pythagorean theorem holds. So Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, where c is the hypotenuse. Our hypotenuse in my triangle right here is this quantity r plus h. And I can call x and r right there, crank in the numbers, come up with this deal, simplify, and we see that the value of x is approximately 2.74 miles. So from that, I can judge that the horizon, from my perspective, is 2.74 miles away, where that's where Rod is. So now this is good theory now. However, I'm someone who, I don't want to let it rest right there. I want to put it into practice. So we're going to the field. We're going to see if we can observe this. Stay tuned. So I feel pretty confident about my theory. I'm pretty sure that it will hold true. However, it's good to have some confirmation. So I'm here with the two smartest people that I know, Rich and Eileen, both math teachers, and I'd like them to arrive at the same conclusion that I did independently from my own work.
What do I do?
Now, So how many miles did you guys come up with?
2.74.
Wendy, how do you think we can demonstrate this in the field?
Well, I think if you're going to take a measurement, you need to really think about making sure you have a consistently flat surface. You need to go somewhere like the water.
That's a good idea. We're on Long Island. We can do something with the bay. Let's think about that. So this is what I came up with. Tell me what you think. Getting a laser and placing it right near the water there, leveling it out such that its beam will form a right angle with a radius of the Earth. Now, I could take some float and place it right there in the water, right near the laser, and mark where that beam hits the float, or the distance above sea level. Take the float then and move it some distance away, and record where the beam hits the float a second time. Due to the curvature of the Earth, one would think that we'd be able to measure this differential. Due to limitations with the laser equipment that I'm going to be using, I'll be unable to shoot a beam 2.74 miles across the water. I will, however, be able to observe half mile distance. So I'm going to scale the experiment down, and based on the calculations, I should witness a 2-inch differential instead of a 5-foot differential. I think this will still prove the point. It's 5 a.m. Rich and I are setting out to the Great South Bay, nice calm conditions, hopefully, to see if we can confirm our calculations. So there seems to be a comedy of errors here. We're out again. Take two. Preparations A through G were complete failures. We're hoping for better results this time.
All right, if you're shooting all this, you can do it help them.
Okay, so I think we have a bit of a confirmation. Let me turn this off. Didn't confirm exactly my calculations, but pretty close. At the laser, it was just a little bit more than 14 inches off the water level. Half a mile away, just about 18 inches. We got a 4-inch differential instead of a 2-inch. I still think that proves the point. To sum up, in scaling the experiment down to a 1/2 mile distance, the calculations predicted that I would have a 2-inch differential. That means that my observation point would be 2 inches above my line of sight, and the position of the laser would represent Rod Stewart out on the horizon sailing. What we actually measured was a 4-inch differential. However, some places that could be accounted for would be the measurement that I had for the radius of the Earth was only accurate to 2 decimal places. Scaling that down 2 inches, I presume some rounding error would incur. Also, I feel that the tide was going out on me. Yet with all that in mind, I still must make the resounding proclamation.
Success!
It needs to hear one word.
Success.
Yes! What a man!